Hi, good morning. It's SMK again, all the way from Mayetin Bokim Christian Center. And we bless God that we have woken up this morning and to a beautiful day that the Lord has made. And to join in and connect with you guys. And we've been missing you, and we believe that you're going to be blessed even this morning in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And we bless God that the chilling weather is about to exit, and warmth will come again, even though in some areas it will mean the departure of summer and the introduction of winter. That's life. Those are seasons that have been made by God that we should live within them. Hallelujah. Today we, like you may have seen, we are going to talk about operational faith and its rewards. Operational faith and its rewards. And we're going to get our scripture reading from the famous book that we've always we've always loved and we've always read and quoted and sometimes misquoted and misconstrued, but it is still a powerful scripture. Hallelujah. I call this scripture the heartbeat of the Christian faith. The heartbeat of the Christian faith. Hallelujah. Now we are reading from Hebrews chapter 11, and we are reading verse 1, and we will also read verse 3. And it reads thus from my Bible: Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Hallelujah. The evidence of things not seen. By faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made from things which are visible. Let's pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, your anointed Son, we come before the throne of grace this morning, carrying the world on our wings of faith. Lord God Almighty, we pray, O God, for planet Earth. Lord, we have sinned, we have disobeyed, we have rebelled, we have shifted away from where you want us to be. But Lord, we have no other God but you, and no one else can save us save you, for there is no other name that is given in heaven and on earth by which men can be saved, save the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It is in this understanding and this hope that we come to you this morning, O God, boldly so, for we've been sprinkled by the blood of the Lamb, qualified to come to you before the throne as your own and cry unto our Father and say, Lord, help us, save us, restore us, protect us, and elevate us in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we pray that the transmission of your word today, even the ones that they have already preached and the ones that are coming to preach, Father God, may they be anointed, O God, to speak of your oracles, and may your people, O God, find help and peace in you and you alone. In Jesus' mighty name, Father God, we pray and we believe it is granted and done. Amen. Operational faith and its rewards. Hallelujah. Now, for us to understand what we will be talking about, we need to define and interpret certain words that I call the key words in the portion of scripture that we have read. These are key words because they make us understand fully what the writer was portraying in line with faith. And it is in the understanding of these words that the whole of the Bible will make sense. It is in the understanding of these words that even the things that are tabulated underneath will make sense and will begin to connect and acclimatize with. My goodness me, and we will be able to see ourselves through the eyes of the writer and be moved and encouraged to believe God more and to step up and walk on our most holy faith. My goodness me, for the Lord has triumphed. My goodness me, Jesus has been risen from the dead. He has triumphed, and it is in the triumph of Christ Jesus wherein we will be able to celebrate and continue to build ourselves in the Lord and strengthen ourselves in the Lord as David did in the past. Hallelujah. These are the key words that we need to look at. There are about three of them in the first verse. Hallelujah. The third verse, we read it so that we should understand that everything was done by God through His word. And therefore, if it was through the word, the universe was created and established through the word. Therefore, we can have faith in God's word, that His word is powerful enough to bring forth that which the Lord has promised. Hallelujah. And to continue to build and sustain us as the Lord has promised, and to reveal and uncover and present us with all the goodies according to the riches and glory as the Lord has promised. For His word is authentic, His word is powerful, His word is truthful, His word is real, and His word will stand the test of time. Hallelujah. The first key word that we find in this portion of scripture is the word substance. Now we have been quoting this scripture and getting excited when we were speaking on this scripture and saying now faith is the substance of the things that are hoped for and the evidence of things that are not seen. My goodness me, are you hearing me here? So substance, what is substance? Substance by definition, it's a tangible, undisputable reality, proof of existence, and an exhibit used for conclusive orders. Hallelujah. Let me repeat, a tangible, undisputable reality, proof of existence, an exhibit used for conclusive order. So when we say faith is the substance of things hoped for, we are saying it is the tangible, undisputable reality. It is the proof of existence of the things that we have asked of the Lord or we desire of the Lord. I hear John speaking unto us this morning and saying, for this is our confidence, that we know that when we speak, He hears us. And because we know that God hears us when we speak, therefore we know that we have the things that we've asked of Him. And even before we can see that with our naked eyes, our natural eyes, therefore we give thanks because we are much assured. We have the assurance, my goodness me, that the Lord has already done it. That is faith. Hallelujah. That is the substance. Are you hearing me? In other words, we speak unto the Lord as we pray and ask of Him the things that we desire of Him. My goodness me. And what already the Lord has concluded, let it be known, it has already been concluded. What is left is for the things to be uncovered and revealed in the natural, because in the spiritual they're already done, sealed. My goodness be, they're already packed with your name tag on it. Are you hearing me? My goodness me, that's the substance. In other words, it is tangible. Even though naturality cannot be able to touch it, even though naturality cannot be able to see it nor comprehend it at times, my goodness me, but it is tangible. There is a proof that the Lord has done what we have asked of him. How do we know this? It's because the Bible tells us that faithful is he who has promised, and he is so just that he will fully accomplish the work that which he has begun. Are you hearing me? And the promises of the Lord are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. So we know what the Lord is saying to us is substantial. It is evident, my goodness me, that the Lord is truthful and he will do exactly as he has promised. It is the substance, a tangible, undisputable reality. Are you hearing me? My goodness me, I'm excited here. I'm also fueled up to believe God even more. My goodness me, it is a tangible, undisputable reality that we have the things that God has promised. As Paul would write and say when he wrote to the Romans, my goodness me, now all things work for good for those who love the Lord, who are called according to his promise. Are you hearing me? My goodness me. And we are more than conquerors because of Christ. So that there is evidence. It is tangible. It is undisputable. My goodness me, there is a tangible, undisputable truth, reality that Jesus rose from the dead. How do we know that? My goodness me, even though other faith and other spiritists and magicians can claim that they are able to perform miracles, which is true, my goodness me, they can perform miracles, but there is a miracle which they cannot perform, the transformation of the human soul. So we have proof that Jesus rose from the dead, because the power of his name, his influence, is able to totally transform us and make us, my goodness, something that we wouldn't have been without Christ coming into our lives. My goodness me, many of you can testify like myself. My goodness me, I was a young man who had no direction, full of anger, running straight to the grave at a young age. But Christ came and arrested my heart, and he transformed me into an instrument that is able to transform lives. Only Christ can do that. No form of deep meditation can bring total transformation. My goodness me, no amount of observing the law can bring transformation. So it is a tangible, undisputable reality that my faith in Christ Jesus, its yielding will continue to yield and ultimately will bring me into a fruitful field. My goodness me, because the same faith in operation will be able to sustain me as I forge my way throughout life. My goodness me, and the same faith will propel me to continue believing hidden in God and sustained by His word and the promises that are in His word. And the same faith is going to bring me to the ultimate end, where I will live outside the presence of sin and completely given victory over the enemy. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Are you with me here? My goodness me, it is the substance, the foolproof of existence, an exhibit used for conclusive order. The second key word is things hoped for. What is hope? My goodness, I, the,